ChatGPT-4, it's out and it's ready to play. What did I just say? There is nothing quite like ChatGPT, but there's also nothing like not knowing how to use the thing and then claiming it's like one of the most amazing things on the planet. We do seriously have to consider how we're using the application before we just go, oh, look how great this is. Like, if you don't know what you're doing, you're just wasting your time using an app that has a lot of power behind it. So in this video, we're gonna get into 5 ChatGPT hacks that'll help you improve your productivity, maybe even your life. Number one, the ChatGPT API. So for those of you that don't know, if you are a member of ChatGPT Plus, or if you're somebody who has signed up to their mailing list, you're gonna get an email bringing you to this page. And even if you're not on those things, you can find the ChatGPT 4 API waitlist here. Now, why might you wanna use it? Well, the reason is if you end up going into your OpenAI account, this is going to be a more customizable way to use ChatGPT 4. So if we go here, the temperature essentially changes how creative it is. And when we work in this system, it's a little bit different than what you're gonna get in the front end experience, because you're able to adjust different things like how creative it's gonna be. And you're able to pick between the different models that you have access to. And this leads me to my second tip, which is this thing can code. Y'all know that? If you go anywhere on Twitter or just Google it, there are so many different things people have made. People have made full-fledged applications using ChatGPT's new model 4. Some guy even made a website that allows people to create their own video games in this website extremely easily. It just, like, he made Pong within a couple seconds and then said, all right guys, like, go on this website, type this prompt in, and you can make whatever game you want. So I was messing around with an idea the other day about making an app picker. I said, all right, ChatGPT, you're a website building AI, create a website called App Picker. This website will allow basically people to go in and figure out what app's best for them. Please spit out the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript for this website to be themed like Notion. And then as you can see, it just runs the code. I don't even know how to respond to this. Now, obviously it's not gonna be perfect, but say for example, I were to take this code and drop it into CodePen, which is like an example code builder, just paste this in here. You'll see that the app picker actually has some grounds to stand on. I even asked it to give an algorithm or what determines the best app based on the person's preferences. And in the source code, you'll see that it did some if-then logic based on this. Now, obviously you can tweak this kind of stuff and go more advanced with it, but it's just insane that this is even possible in the first place. And people have done a lot more than this, but this is a half decent start that you wouldn't have otherwise. Number three, Chrome extensions. Now, just getting started, there is this example one called Web ChatGPT, which is essentially just taking ChatGPT and giving internet access. So if I add this to my web browser, it'll open up ChatGPT in my browser. And now on the bottom, you'll see that there's some web access. It says 3 results. And then, like, when do you want it to go check? So default prompt. Okay, that's pretty interesting. So say I were to do a basic Google search of, I go last week, when did ChatGPT 4 release? And then you can see web search results. OpenAI chat was just released AI model. It's got the hyperlinks to Search Engine Journal, which is a paid search and SEO journal website. It's got news articles from Vox. According to the provided results, ChatGPT 4 was officially released on March 13th. So what you're seeing here is it's giving you web references and then giving you a spit out of this prompt wise. I really like this. It's giving you information, then querying it. Very basic prompt understanding, but this is the kind of stuff that you can do. Is these people are making these amazing add-ons, and I'm going to make an entire video on that moving forward, because they really can level up your productivity. Number four, prompt sequences. So earlier today I was making a Twitter thread. I said, hey ChatGPT, your story engine, take this information, turn it into a tweet thread, okay? And then it did its thing, you know. It wasn't awful, but it wasn't 12 out of 10. It was like 7 out of 10. But what you're going to do if you're using ChatGPT is not just doing one baseline thing. You then have to tell it, after doing the first thing, following the exact same structure, incorporate a couple quippy statements about self-deprecating humor, because I like making fun of myself in my content. And then it did it. And then I said, wait a second, can you reference the audience? Following the same structure throughout the story, break the fourth wall. And then it did it with little snippets like, ever been there? Sound familiar? And then all I have to do is, in the last step here, basically say, all right, can you get rid of the dang platitudes? And then it did it. Rather than just taking baseline prompts and baseline information, what you need to do is you need to tell it to do something. First, and then tweak it over and over again. You need to become a great curator when using this thing. The human aspect cannot be lost. It is very important that you do this. Now, if you notice something in this process, I just gave it a story. But what you also can do is you can take baseline information from other things, similar to what that web ChatGPT 3 thing did, and you can essentially prime it with different context. So now I'm gonna take an example prompt I had, especially with ChatGPT 4, and I'm gonna turn them off web access. And I'm just gonna paste this in here. So what this prompt does is it basically gives ChatGPT a bunch of different examples. As you can see here, I have example tweets. So story engine, here are some example tweets. This is a great structure that I found. So now on the bottom here, what I'm basically gonna do is say, today I woke up at 5 a.m. and got to work. It might be a Sunday, but it's absolutely worth it to work on the weekends if it means I'll have freedom in the future. Now, after I press enter here, what'll happen is, especially with ChatGPT 4, is it'll really mimic the style that you saw earlier, right? You see how it's got this whole breakdown with the bullet points and whatnot? Okay, so now we'll look at this output. Embrace the 5 a.m. hustle for 3 weeks straight. Productivity skyrocketed. Uninterrupted work on the weekends. Future freedom in sight. Sunday or not, the grind brings long-term rewards. That is a good tweet. And it's doing 3 of them because I gave it 3 examples. You cannot make this up. This is something new that you're getting with ChatGPT 4 that you're just not getting in the previous versions of this. I'm able to give it context, give it a structure, and it's like, all right, bet, let's do it. ChatGPT 4 is going to be a game changer, whether you want to jump on or not. Just like you might want to jump on subscribing to this channel for more AI tips and more tips on how to improve your productivity, just like this one right here.